they like what I say because I'm saying what they feel. I'm scratching their itch type of deal.
When they tell you what they think, believe them. Paul tells Titus in chapter 2, verse 1, that you should teach what accords with sound doctrine. And he goes on and says, as a matter of fact, before he even makes that statement, he says in Titus 1, 9, he says, holding fast the faithful word, which is in accordance with the teaching, so that you will be able to both exhort sound doctrine and to refute those who contradict. So he's making the point that you should exhort sound doctrine as well as refute those who contradict it. There are many who will say that when someone teaches something that's wrong, that's false, a heresy, something that is dangerous for the body, that you should just leave it alone, that you should pray for the person, don't call them out. Who are you to judge? But the fact of the matter is that is not what Paul says. And if you listen to them, such as we'll listen to a Greg Locke in just a second, you'll hear him tell what's kind of behind him. You'll hear his thought pattern. As a matter of fact, it's something that we've said before that they really do, according to what Paul says. We're going to look at the passage Paul brings up, that they want to just appeal to people what they want to hear, give them what they want to hear.
For the most part, I'm preaching to a pretty one-sided crowd. That's why they're flying here, driving here, taking a bicycle or a cruise ship here, because they like what I say, because I'm saying what they feel. I'm scratching their itch type of deal.
Now, this is an older interview that he did with CBS, and so this is kind of when he was a little bit more political, but he was still giving, at the time, still some bad teaching, and even more so now. But still, his heart then is the same as it is now.
They like what I say because I'm saying what they feel. I'm scratching their itch type of deal. And so they already know where the evidence is. And plus, kind of like Jesus, he would say things to make you go do your own investigation. I have absolutely no worries at all that they're ever going to come back on me, and almost wish that they would, so the evidence would come to the surface.
Now, when he makes a statement that they like what he says and he's scratching their itch, that literally comes from what the Bible says, and he is fulfilling in the wrong way, negatively, what Paul has warned against. The Bible says in 2 Timothy chapter 4, starting in verse 2, he says, preach the word, be ready in season and in out of season. And notice what he says. He says, reprove, that means to prove someone who is wrong, in error, prove them, show them the right way. He says, rebuke, that is, if they don't want to listen to it, if they don't want to change, rebuke them. He says, to exhort with great patience and instruction. How often? That means constantly. With long suffering or great patience. He says, for the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. People like him and others, they might promote unsound doctrine. So what do? We promote sound doctrine and we refute those who contradict it. And then it says that, but wanting to have their ears tickled, they will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance with their own desires. And some verses might say having itching ears. And that's what he's saying. He knows, he understands full well what he's saying. If you have, and it's what we've been trying to warn people about, there are those that want to hear certain things. They want certain things preached to them. They want to know that certain things aren't their fault. Maybe it's a demon. They want to know that they can get good things out of life, that you can have your best life, your blessed life, that you can call things that are not as though they were. Even though none of these things are actually happening in the real world, they'll cause you to, one, fall in love with what they're saying, and believe it. If you're going through something's bad, well, then it's a demon. Because you're frustrated, then it's not you, it's not your sin, it's not your lack of devotion to the word, it's something else. And so because you're hearing what someone wants to say, they're going to find a way to give you what you want to hear. So he says they will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance with their own desires. There will be a lot of people that will turn to false teachings. If you have any idea as to who a false teacher is, one, we tend to call it out, not all the time, not with everyone, because again, the majority of what anyone should be doing, the majority of what any person teaching or preaching should be doing should be sound doctrine. But that does not mean that you ignore when someone brings about faulty doctrine. This is literally a command from Paul. And you're going to find out that those that tend to promote bad doctrine, either something that doesn't hold folks accountable to their sin, either something that distorts the nature or the identity of Jesus, his deity, those that would say that you can be possessed by a demon even though you have the Holy Spirit in you, meaning that God's Spirit in you, that Jesus setting you free is not enough, but them laying their hands on you is enough. Those that promote some sort of false prophecy that makes you feel good about yourself, that you're going to have some sort of blessing to come, you're going to see these little bad or aberrant theologies, these bad or aberrant doctrines. you're going to see those are going to be the most popular views on not just YouTube, not just Facebook, but anywhere, but even in churches. Look at the churches that are just growing in size because you're promising them something. Paul is saying the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine. So when you see some of these different views being preached, this is why. The time will come when folks will not endure sound doctrine. What will they have? What's the opposite of sound doctrine? Unsound doctrine. So when you see that some of these unsound views growing, it's not because it's God behind it. It's not that God is causing them to grow. It's not because that it's God that's causing sound doctrine to go by the wayside. No, this is just what he said. What does he say? He says they will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance to their own desires. That's why you see some of the larger churches. I'm not saying all big churches have bad doctrine. I don't want you to misunderstand me. And I'm not saying that all people with the largest followers on social media, those are all bad teachers. That's not what I'm saying. But when you see them growing and exploding, ask yourself why. Because rarely are we seeing those that are exploding in a rapid fashion, those being those with sound doctrine. That's not always the case. But in many cases, go and check their doctrine. They will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance with their own desires and will turn away their ears from the truth and will turn aside to myths. But what does he say? But you be sober in all things, endure hardship, do the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. And notice, Paul is on his deathbed. And so as Paul is on his deathbed, he's not simply talking about sound doctrine. That's the forefront of it. But in order to promote sound doctrine, you have to also refute bad doctrine. And at the very end, he says to be on guard of Alexander the coppersmith. He did us much harm. The Lord will pay him. Why? Because he opposed this message. He opposed sound teaching. Be on guard against him yourself, for he vigorously opposed our teaching. Not just him, but others like him. But remember, and they don't have to run. They don't have to shy back from it. They don't have to be afraid to admit it, that people have itching ears. And so he's giving them, he's scratching their itch. And he's almost daring them to go and search the scriptures for themselves. He knows full well, just like everyone else knows, that too many Christians are lazy and are not wanting to go and search the scriptures for themselves. Instead, they want you to tell them. Tell them what the scriptures say. Tell them what their problem is. But then more than that, tell them how they can feel better. Give them some more lies to help them to forget about the truth. That's the whole goal. And then you would in turn enrich yourself. You would move people away from the gospel, whether you say that's your intent or not. There are those that teach falsely who do so as they are deceived. There are those that do it unintentionally, those who do it intentionally. The result is still the same, though, whether a person teaches false doctrine unintentionally or intentionally, whether they preach a heresy intentionally or unintentionally, there's still a soul at the end of that is hurt by that. So what are we to do? Like Paul said, we call those things out. Remember, this is Paul on his deathbed reminding people to be on guard about false teachers. And the fact is, here we have someone who is telling us the secret, telling us the truth. And the fact is, people are still not listening, even after he himself gives you the warning. Like you see on a lot of these drug products and so forth, you got these warning labels, and people still refuse to look at the warning. He's telling you, and people won't listen, which is why you need people to, one, give good doctrine, while at the same time, whenever you see it, you call it out. And that's what we need to do, all of us. Amen.